When you write sequences with moving lights, often what you envision is a sequence where lights fade up nicely, they fade out nicely, and then somehow magically, they fade up nicely again. What often happens in real life, however, is that you write a look and you see the lights move into position, they fade out, and then you hit go and they do some nasty things and move into position again. This happens less and less as consoles have new default modes in them, and that's what I'm going to talk about now is the default mode of Automark in Cobalt. The first part of this sequence is written with Automark enabled. The second half of this sequence was written with it defeated. So we try to make it possible for your queuing to look absolutely stunning all the time. And we do that by providing this Automark setting in the sequence editor. So you can see the attribute move column in the sequence editor. The first three steps are listed with Automark enabled, and the last three steps in order to make the demonstration were changed manually to go on go. What that means is that all of the attributes in a look get executed when you hit the go button, which seems to make some simple logical sense. But what that means in our fade up, fade out, fade up somewhere else scenario is that the act of turning the light off doesn't necessarily tell the light and get ready for the next look by fading in the dark to your new positions. That's what Automark does. Automark uses a special kind of logic in the system based on playing back sequences. So when you go from one step to the next, every time you go to a step with Automark enabled, the system asks all the channels that are in the incoming, the next look, if they're on. And if they're not on, are they about to be on and in a different position than where they are right now? If that question is answered, I'm off in live, and that means off from the sequence playback, off from independent control, and off from master's control and manual control, completely out. And I'm about to turn on and go somewhere else. The go somewhere else commands will be executed between the crossfades, between the go hits. So every time a crossfade completes, the system does that check for you to see if lights are going to be on and somewhere else in the next look. And if the answer is yes, it moves them into position in the dark. So we'll look at that real quickly once again. Hit go to Q0 or zero go to in this case. Automark's enabled, so the lights preset themselves in the dark for 1001. And when I hit go, they fade up very nicely in our pink gobo look. Then I tell them to fade out in the next preset, and you can see them moving into position in the dark. And then I hit go again, and they come up in our green spiral gobos nice and cleanly. That's Automark logic working for you. Sometimes doing that automarking in the next step doesn't give you enough time for that mark to complete. Sometimes that's not the appropriate place for lights to be moving in the dark. It could be that that moment in the show is simply too quiet for the automark to happen in a non-noticeable manner. So what you might want to do is move the marking command manually to an earlier step in your sequence. The way you can deal with that is by using the mark key on the console. So if I wanted to record these lights in this green gobo in some other look in my sequence, I can do so by simply marking them, which sends their intensity to as close to zero as possible without making them unimportant to the record if active logic. And then I can record them or update them into whatever preset or cue I wish. This gives me control over when that mark happens in the case that the auto mark doesn't have enough time or isn't the right spot.